Welcome, let's talk about the IAS prelims paper 2019. Now we'll be talking about the first 25 questions in this set. So the first question talks about the nitrogen content in the atmosphere. So agriculture definitely releases a lot of nitrous oxides into the environment. So that's correct. When we say for the poultry, you have a higher consumption of protein, that would lead to higher release of ammonia into the atmosphere. Again, reactive nitrogen, so nitrogen by natural is inert, but you have reactive nitrogen in the form of ammonia, ammonium, and all these are released into the atmosphere through agriculture, through poultry, livestock. So all these three statements becomes the correct statement. Now note, there were lots and lots of questions from Down to Earth and the Hindu in the first 25 sections that we have done. Now Aliyar, Isapur and Kanspati have been known for water reservoir, so water reservoir dam rehabilitation project that came in, these have been in news. Hydrogen enriched CNG, it is expensive than the normal CNG. It reduces the proportion of carbon monoxide by 70%. So first is incorrect, fourth is incorrect. Only 2 and 3 are the correct options here. So 2 and 3 would be the right options. The next is, dewdrops are not formed on the cloudy night because the clouds would reflect the heat back. As a result, the condensation would not take place. And therefore, you have B as the right option here. Now, this article placing the election of Prime Minister beyond the judicial review was given in 39th Amendment. So, first becomes incorrect, the second becomes the correct statement. So, you have 2 as the right option. A lot of questions from judicial review. So, these are all part of the NGAC recommendations, and you have a lot of portions from the Hindu, as I said. Now, the motion to impeach the judge of Supreme Court can be rejected by the speaker, so this becomes incorrect. The motion must be taken by 2/3 of the members present and voting in both the houses, and the details of the process for impeachment are given in the Judges Inquiry Act 68. So 2, 3 and 4 are the right options. 9th schedule was laid down by Jawaharlal Nehru and it focused mainly on the chapter on fundamental rights. So Jawaharlal Nehru is the right option. Now coal sector was nationalized by Indira Gandhi, that's correct. It is allocated on an auction basis, so this becomes incorrect. And till now we are importing coal, so 3 also becomes incorrect. 1 only is the right option. The next question talks about the office of profit. So office of profit is not well defined in the constitution. Now since it's not well defined in the constitution, the only correct option that could be there is the first one. The next is, the 5th schedule talks about the transfer of tribal land to private mining can be declared null and void. So very, very important, and the part of recent the Hindu edition. So very, very important question that was there. The next was Himalayan nettle. Now Himalayan nettle is a kind of textile fiber that has been used by Khar community. It's mainly in the far east areas of Nepal. This was a special case study brought under Down to Earth. So very, very important. The next is very important question from GIS. So you have satellite image and remote sensing data that can measure and estimate the chlorophyll content of the vegetation, the greenhouse emission from the rice paddies and the land surface temperature. So all these are the correct options here. The next question is, in terms of the percentage cover to the total area, so Maharashtra has the least, which is 16.4% nearly, with Chhattisgarh having the most, around 41%. So after Maharashtra, the next holds by Madhya Pradesh. So it's 3, 2, 4 and 1 as the correct option. So 3, 2, 4 and 1 become the correct option. The next is methane hydrate. So methane hydrate definitely triggers the release of methane gas. Also, it is found in the permafrost area, continental margins and deep sea floor. So 2 is again correct. And methane oxidizes to carbon dioxide after a decade. That's true because the residence time for methane is 9 years. So that can again be proved. So all of those become the right statement here. Now, which of the gases have been released into the atmosphere as a result of crop residue. So when you are burning the crop residue, which has been a recent issue of Delhi smog, we have covered a separate lecture on Delhi smog, the Lancet committee report, and this has been part of the Down to Earth edition again. So you have carbon monoxide and sulfur dioxide as the right answer. Besides that, you have particulate matter and black carbon, that is part of it. Now, which of those are the correct matches? So you have Adriatic Sea with Albania, Caspian Sea with Kazakhstan, and Mediterranean Sea with Morocco. Those are the right options. So Black Sea is very far from Croatia and Red Sea not near Syria. So you have 1, 3 and 4 as the right options here. Okay. The next question is, India is the largest exporter of rice since 2011 and 12 when it overbeat Thailand. So right now the answer is India. Again, an article from The Hindu. Now, which glaciers? So Siachen Glacier leads to Nubra River. You have the Bandarpunch Glacier, which feeds to one of the rivers, which is called as the Hanuman Ganga, which finally joins into Yamuna. So that's the correct option. And Barashringi joins with Chenab. So 1, 2 and 4 are the correct options. The next is, in India, use of carbofuran, methyl perithion has been in agriculture as pesticides, but however it has been viewed with apprehension as of now. So pesticides in agriculture is the right option. Now, Ramsar Convention is not mandatory. However, the rules are framed by Government of India, Ministry of Environment and Forest Department. So you have 2 and 3 as the right options. However, this wetland rules 2010 does not take into account the coastal wetlands and the coastal paddy fields. But 2 and 3 are the right options here. Now, Kalyan Mandapa is a notable feature of Vijayanagar Empire. Very, very important. So it was mainly seen in the Rameshwaram temple and the Seshagiri temples in Srirangam, where you have Kalyan Mandapams that are seen. So Vijayanagar Empire has been a classic example for developing of this system. Mir Bakshi was the office of military held during the Mughal period. So only 1 and 2 are the correct options. So Ikta was an ancient indigenous system of Delhi Sultan. However, it was seen mainly from it was not indigenous within the system, because it mainly came from Mughals. Okay, so Ikta system of the Sultan of Delhi was an indigenous is incorrect. Okay, the revenue administration in Delhi Sultanate was in charge of Amil, that is correct. So one only is the right answer. The next question is, Saint Nimbark was not contemporary of Akbar. So that's incorrect. Saint Nimbark was a student of Ramanujan or a disciple of Ramanujan, and they were on the time of Bhakti movement, which came much prior to the Sufi movement. Similarly, during this time, the Sheikh Ahmad Shirhindi was in the time of Akbar. So Sant Kabir was not influenced by it. So neither, so this last choice is missing, sorry. So neither 1 and 2 are the correct options. Okay, the next is, with reference to British colonial rule in India, consider the following statement. So Mahatma Gandhi was instrumental in abolition of indentured labor, that is true. In Lord Chelmsford War Conference, Mahatma Gandhi did support the resolution on recruiting Indians for World War, and breaking of the salt laws was declared illegal by the colonial rulers. So that's again correct. So 1 and 3 are the right options here. Now, Montego Chelmsford, as we already said, was a very important topic this year, because you had the 100th anniversary of Montego Chelmsford reform. The next was, Tej Bahadur Zafar was the president of All India Liberation, Negoi a member of Constituent Assembly, and P.C. Joshi the general secretary of CPI, the first general secretary of CPI. So all these three have been the right statements. With this, we finish the first set. We'll be coming up with the next three sets. So stay tuned, stay subscribed for further updates. Have a wonderful day ahead.